It was meant to be the dream vacation for a family, but the Utah family's trip, sadly, to the islands ended in tragedy when their 5-year-old son drowned.
I spoke with the boys' parents who hope sharing their story can prevent this from happening again.
This is 5-year-old Noah Martin, or Mr. Noah, as his family like to call him.
He was really smart. That's why we used to call him Mr. Noah since he was a baby, because he was so smart.
Noah, his parents, and his 8 brothers and sisters, ranging in age from a year and a half to 14 years old, flew to Hawaii from Utah for a family vacation over spring break.
It was a dream come true. We were so happy. Kids were happy. Yeah, everything about the trip was so fun for the kids.
They planned to stay a week. The goal? Visit as many beaches as possible and bask in Hawaii's clear blue waters. Their second day on Oahu, March 15th, they headed to Ko'olina Lagoon 4.
We was there all day. We was just snorkeling all day.
I was sitting on the beach, and my husband was down at the bottom with our youngest son. We were just preparing to leave so that we could watch the sunset from up top.
That's when they heard someone yell.
Help. All I heard was help. So I started to make my way down. And that's when I seen my son.
She says he was unresponsive as a Good Samaritan pulled him from the water and administered CPR.
Perfect strangers that ran to help us, because I was in such shock that it happened so fast. I couldn't even speak. I couldn't even breathe. It just felt like a nightmare.
EMS and the fire department responded, but Noah was gone.
Becca says Noah and his siblings were near the shallow end of the lagoon and that the water was calm, so she thought they would be okay. According to the CDC, drownings can happen in just a few inches of water and are often silent. And despite being criticized, Becca wanted to share her story with the hope of preventing another tragedy.
These type of situations can happen literally within the shortest amount of time. Just love your kids. And just to appreciate life.
The Martins also wanted to recognize the first responders who helped Noah. They say they didn't give up, didn't leave Noah's side for a second, and treated him as if he was one of their own children. I was told that Ko'olina Lagoon 4 did not have a lifeguard on duty at the time of the incident. I reached out to Ko'olina and they told me they do not have any plans to make any changes at this time.